From DocuSign, this is Developing with DocuSign. I'm Larry Kluger, a member of the DocuSign Dev Center team. In this video, I'll be discussing integration keys, what they are, when you need them, what they do, and much more. To build an application that integrates with DocuSign via one of our APIs, you usually need an integration key. There are some exceptions. The DocuSign Signature appliance does not use integration keys, and there are some Connect webhook applications that don't need integration keys either. If you're planning to use an application from an independent software vendor, an ISV, ask the ISV if they'll be supplying the IK or if you will need to. I'll discuss more about ISV applications later in the video. An integration key represents an application, so it has one owner. The application, with its IK, can be used by anyone on any account that includes API support. Let's start with the basic API call. Most DocuSign APIs require that an OAuth access token is included with every API request. The access token is sent to DocuSign in the authentication HTTP header of the API request. And to obtain an access token, your application needs an integration key. We recommend that your application uses an OAuth flow and the DocuSign authentication server to obtain access tokens. By using OAuth, your application authenticates on behalf of your user without seeing the user's password. During the early stages of development, you can also hard code an access token, but that can only be a temporary step since access tokens only last a maximum of 8 hours. An integration key is an alphanumeric identifier used to identify your application. It uses the GUID or Global Universal ID format. You can see an example of an integration key on the screen. The terms integrator key, integration key, and client ID are all synonyms and mean the same thing. The OAuth community uses the term client ID. DocuSign prefers the term integration key, but has used integrator key in the past. Each of your applications should have its own integration key. New versions of an application do not need a new IK. In this video, I'll be using the terms integration key and client ID. Note that none of the integration keys or other private information shown in this video are real. They're all examples that do not actually work on the DocuSign systems. Integration keys are unique within the scope of the DocuSign sandbox system, that is, the demo system. A demo integration key is different from a production integration key, even if they have the same value. They have two different management accounts and two different sets of settings. For example, you use the developer sandbox system to create integration key 123. When your application is ready for production, you'll complete the go-live process. You now have two different integration keys. Both have the value 123. They will have different secrets and other settings. The first one can still be used on the demo system. The second one can be used on the production systems. If you've purchased an application from an independent software vendor, an ISV, that is integrated with DocuSign, you may or may not need your own integration key. ISV applications should usually include their own integration key. Ask your ISV or the person installing your software whether or not you'll need your own IK for the application. If you will need your own IK, then the software vendor should help you create the integration key and move it to the production systems. Integration key charges. Creating, testing, and using integration keys is free on the developer sandbox system. Moving an integration key to the production systems, that's the go-live process, is also free. Envelope charges are based on the user and their production account plan, not on the application used. For example, Daryl developer creates an application and integration key. Charlie customer uses the application. Charlie is charged for his DocuSign production account usage. Daryl is not. Using an integration key. An integration key can be used by any user on any account that includes API support to obtain an access token. You do not have to enable access to an account. All IKs can always be used by any account. Managing IK. Exactly one account, the IK's management account, is used to manage an IK to view and change its settings. An integration key's management account is simply a DocuSign account that can change the IK's settings. When you create an IK in demo, the account you used becomes the management account for the new IK. When you use the go-live process to enable the IK on production, you choose which paid production account will also become the production management account for the IK. Software vendors who are a member of the DocuSign Partner Program can obtain a no-charge partner account on the production systems that can be used to manage production integration keys. All integration keys are created in the developer sandbox system, that's demo.docusign.net. When your application is ready for the production system, the go-live process is used. After the go-live process, you will have two integration keys, the original integration key on demo and a new integration key, same value but different settings, on production. You can still use your original IK on demo after completing the go-live process. Integration keys have many attributes and more may be added in the future. You can view and update an integration key's attributes by using the administration tool on the key's management account. An IK in production can be used by any user in any account that includes API access on any DocuSign platform, North America, Europe, Australia, etc. Users will only have access to your application if you provide your application to the user. Your application can only use the API methods and features included in the account's plan. For example, payments are not included in all types of accounts. You cannot delete an IK. Instead, rename it to old and delete its secrets, private keys, etc. These next couple of slides are for independent software vendors. If your software is a cloud-based application, then your application should have one integration key which you control and manage. Your customers do not and should not need to create or manage an IK. Your customers do not need to know your application's IK and must not know your IK's secrets or private keys. You should use authorization code grant whenever a user is present to configure or use your application. If your application is installed on-premises, then each of your customers should have a different production IK. The best options for you to generate the IK, then use the go-live process and work with your customer to move the IK to production. The management account should belong to your customer. In the future, if your application is on-premises, then our plan is that you, the ISV, will be able to create IKs for your customers. These IKs will be available on production immediately with no go-live process required. They will be associated with your application's IK. If you're interested in this plan, please ask your DocuSign representative or customer service to add your name and account information to internal tracking number DPE-136. Thank you very much for watching this video about DocuSign integration keys, and thank you for integrating with DocuSign.